Ken Loach's last film in his Northeast trilogy has had its official screening in Cannes. The acclaimed director, who's now in his 80s, has said The Old Oak is likely to be his final full-length feature. Well, in the second of Sharuna Sagar's exclusive reports, she joins the filmmaker and his team behind the scenes as they unveil their story of Syrian refugees in an East Durham mining community to the world.
Come for Team Loach to unveil their movie baby. The Old Oak is the hotly anticipated swan song for the film director who conquered Cannes.
You are revered here. Revered on the Riviera, aren't you?
You can exaggerate that. No, I mean, mainly I walk around and there's, you know, it's fine.
This could be your last Cannes.
It could. I mean, I might come back and just to see what's going on, really. Try not to think about it being the last anything, really.
This is the iconic red carpet at Cannes. It leads up to the Lumiere, the biggest auditorium at the festival. And don't be fooled by this oasis of calm right now, because as soon as that guy finishes hoovering, this place is going to be heaving.
But first, there's the foreign press publicity machine to feed. And understandably, there's a lot of interest in the two unknowns plucked out of obscurity to star in The Old Oak, Gateshead's Dave Turner and Syrian actress Ibla Murray, who hasn't yet seen a single frame of her big screen debut.
The premiere will be the first time you get to see the film.
Yes.
How are you feeling about that?
I'm nervous about it, but I think it will be the same result if I see it alone. But of course, I'm nervous to watch myself. I don't know. This is like my first experience.
After several exhausting hours of daunting back-to-back international interviews, our Geordie Everyman turns himself into a leading man and joins the cast and crew for some pre-premiere Dutch, or should I say French, courage.
I'm absolutely relaxed. It might be helpful that I've got this in my hand.
Don't drink any more champagne, Dave.
No.
You look fantastic.
Thank
but
you.
How are you feeling?
I'm so excited for it.
Oh, it's just wonderful to meet with the team who made the film. And you realise how many people go to make a film, you know, from... So it's been a four-year process. To be part of this festival is incredible.
And with that, it's time for a carefully choreographed mass exodus for the moment they've all been waiting for.
Good luck, Ken.
Okay.
It's all very familiar territory for Ken Loach and his filmmaking comrades, producer Rebecca O'Brien and screenwriter Paul Laverty. After all, this is the 15th film he's shown at Cannes, more than any other director in the festival's history.
And with that, the spectacle of the red carpet's over, and it's now time to share their film with the world.
What a response. A 15-minute standing ovation from more than 2,000 people.
You never know how it's going to play, and there's something quite spectacular, you know, kind of sensing an audience in such a beautiful place.
There were quite emotional feelings in the room. Couldn't have been better, really, to be honest.
So, Dave, fresh from the premiere, how was it?
One of the most incredible experiences of my life.
Well, I can't tell right now because it's very overwhelming and it's weird seeing yourself for the first time, but I am truly so proud of this film.
Ken got a great reception, which was only fitting, and he made a lovely speech.
We felt we wanted to make a film about hope.
You were a little bit nervous going in, weren't you?
Well, you're always nervous because you just don't know, you know. It's the first audience that's seen it as a real audience. So, it was extraordinary. If that's reproduced elsewhere, we'll be doing amazing.
Very glamorous indeed. And The Old Oak will go on general release in the UK on the 29th of September. Put it in your diaries.